Hello, my beautiful friends. It is Mimi here today, and I'm so happy to be here with you and excited to share with you my October favorites because I actually have a lot of things to share with you today, things that are very useful in my life. That's what makes it exciting to share with you because I hope they're gonna be just as useful in your life as well. So if you guys are ready, I gotta get started because I got a lot to cover. I'll start today with a few edible favorites. The first one that I have here is organic aloe vera juice. And I have a funny story to tell you because years ago I used to order organic, well, it said it was organic aloe vera juice on Amazon. And literally it tasted like water. For some reason it had really good reviews and everybody said, oh, this is actually what aloe vera is supposed to taste like. And I sort of fell for it, but now after I got this one, I'm pretty convinced I was just buying pure water. This is by the brand Fushi, freshly made from the inner leaf flesh, unfiltered aloe vera juice. And I love that it comes in a glass bottle, but what I was gonna say initially is that the taste is completely different. It tastes like a leaf would taste. It's slightly bitter, it's got texture in it because it's unfiltered, it's not just like water, so you get sort of the pulp of the aloe plant. I keep this in the fridge because it actually tastes better when it's cold. Then the taste is very tolerable, it's actually even pleasant, I would say. So on the bottle here, it says to take 3 to 5 tablespoons. You can use this internally. Usually when I get stressed, the first thing that gets hit in my body is my digestion. Something starts giving me some issues. Like sometimes I get burning sensation in my stomach, and I have this naturopathic holistic doctor that I see regularly, and she told me that this would be really great to take internally. And yeah, I absolutely love this product. It's very cooling to the body, so when you take it in, it feels really great. But also what aloe vera juice is great for, because there's so many beneficial uses for aloe vera, is that you can apply it topically on your skin. So once in a while I would do that as well, and it's supposedly really great for your skin. It smooths your skin, it clears your skin. You can also add it to your hair. This is something I used to do in the summer a lot when my hair would be dry from the sun. So you can leave this as a leave-in conditioner in your hair. Obviously, because aloe vera is mostly water, it hydrates your hair, it adds shine to your hair. So it's got really great benefits. But internally, again, because that's the main reason I wanted to mention it, it has so many benefits. It detoxifies your body, it's great for your immune system. I mean, the list goes on and on and on. I definitely recommend for you to add aloe vera juice, a real aloe vera juice, a cold press version that is unfiltered to your everyday use. I'm actually thinking to maybe buy a real plant and start juicing it myself, but at this point in my life, I just think it's too much hassle, so I prefer to buy this version. So definitely check it out. Next food related favorite that I want to mention today is an organic chicory instant coffee, but it's actually not coffee. It smells sort of like coffee. As you can see, it looks like coffee. It looks like instant coffee. But what this really is an instant chicory root powder. All you do with this is you take a couple of spoons or just one spoon and add hot water. You can drink it as that. Or what I've been doing lately is I use 2 teaspoons of this chicory root powder. I have this little device that I use to create foam in almond milk. So I heat up some almond milk and I make this really nice cappuccino, or they call it chicochino. Here on the bottle, they have a recipe as well. This is by the brand Pruitt's. And I just get this at Whole Foods. I'm not really sure if there's any other great brands for this thing, but I've literally just tried it recently and I really like the taste. But also the chicory plant or the chicory root has so many incredible benefits for the body. It's really good for your liver. It's really good for reducing your stress levels. Again, there's so many incredible health benefits, but I actually just like the taste as well. So I definitely wanted to mention this today in my favorites because I've actually been drinking this every single day and I really, really love it. Next favorite of the month is a new water bottle I have. And I feel like I've gone through so many water bottles over the years. I almost feel bad. But I think I have stopped my search now because I have a few things that I will highlight that I like about this product. So first of all, this is by the brand SIG. Technically, this is a camping water bottle because it serves as a cold water bottle or a hot water bottle. Meaning if you add a hot drink, it's not gonna burn you if you hold it. It's gonna contain the drink really nice and hot or warm. So you can take it out with you and drink your tea, coffee, soup, whatever it is that you're adding inside. And the most important thing that I love about this bottle is that it's light. Now that I have Alexa, whenever I'm out, my bag is full of her stuff as well as my stuff. So I cannot have anything that's heavy. Previously, I used to have a lot of glass water bottles that I would take with me outside. But those I find are just way too heavy to carry with me at the moment. So this one is great because if it's empty, it literally weighs nothing. Another good thing is Alexa uses this as a toy. She loves to play with it. Also, it's made out of aluminum. So aluminum is a more, I would say, environmentally friendly material. So it's good for that as well. It makes me happy knowing that. They have a nice selection and different sizes. Alex has a silver that's like quite big. This one I believe is, I'm not really sure. I think it's half a liter or maybe more. Maybe it's actually a liter. I think it fits about 2 glasses of water. So it should be at least half a liter of water, which is great. So I've been really happy with this bottle. And if you're looking for a water bottle, I would definitely recommend looking to Sig Company. Very excited to share with you my new favorite of the month, and this booty right here is by the brand, but it's BC. It always makes me think of before Christ when I hear BC, but it actually means born in California. That's the brand. But I actually found this brand on Free People. So if you don't wear leather as myself, you probably struggle a lot with finding good quality, comfortable shoes. And I would say that's been my biggest struggle when dressing myself in the last few years. I probably haven't worn leather in about, I would say 5.5, 6 years now. And what I was gonna say is that I was really excited that Free People, actually the website Free People, has a selection that says vegan, and under that selection they have different brands of shoes that have actually non-leather shoes. So if you're looking for non-leather shoes, I believe that will be helpful for you. That's how I found this brand. I really love the style of the booties. I love this really nice detail on the cod. The quality is pretty decent. I'm not gonna lie, it's not amazing. I already scratched the heel right here, trying to hide it. But I always do that. I'm not sure if it's the way I walk or something else. But overall, the quality is not cheap. It's not incredible. It's not like high-end designer, but the price is also more affordable. But it's very comfortable. I'll say that because I walk a lot with Alexa and I need something that is, you know, stylish yet also comfortable that I can walk in and not be in pain. So these booties are super comfortable. Again, really love the style of the booties and would definitely recommend looking to them if you're looking for non-leather booties. Finding good quality non-leather shoes have been such a big struggle for me. Those of you who watch me for the last few years would know this. I actually have some issues with my feet now because the shoes that I buy, sadly, most of the synthetic shoes that are made out there are not good quality. So you can develop some problems with your feet because they're so uncomfortable. But I could even live with that. My biggest issue lately from doing personal research is that a lot of synthetic materials are basically, if you break it down, are plastic. And that can also have a harmful impact on the environment. But then the debate between synthetic and leather is still so huge because leather gets tanned, like real leather gets tanned, and it's also very bad for the environment. So basically, there's no perfect way to live your life. You just have to choose and make the decisions that feel right in your heart. At the moment, I'm considering to perhaps start wearing vintage leather because I think it's the best solution to my problem at the moment. I still want to obviously create my own shoe brand, but for me it's important that the fabric and the quality is great. Those of you again who have watched me in the past know that it's something that I've tried and I haven't succeeded yet, but it's definitely the goal and the dream, part of the dream that I have. So yeah, I'm definitely strongly considering to start wearing vintage leather shoes, and if you do, let me know if you know any great websites that are out there. I'm definitely thinking, considering that I haven't started doing that yet, but because it's been such a big pain point, I wanted to put it out there for you guys maybe who are struggling as well because you don't wear leather. I think it's a great alternative because you're taking an old shoe and you are the solution in recycling that shoe instead of ending somewhere in a dumpster. You know, it's gonna end in your wardrobe and you're actually gonna use it because it's already been made. So you might as well recycle that shoe and use it, and nothing new has to be made as well. Just a thought for you to digest if you do wear leather or don't wear leather. And I'm gonna go into my next favorite, which is also a fashion item. I have a collection here of Berets. And again, those of you who've been watching me know that I love berets. I wear them all the time, but they're actually in style right now, which is very exciting. These are old. I bought these at American Apparel because a lot of times I wear my berets. You guys ask me on Instagram, where did you get this? So I thought I'd mention it because they've been my favorites for some time now. So these two I actually got a while ago from American Apparel. I think they are not in business anymore. I'm not really sure. You have to check. But these two that I got this year, I really love this one because it's pale pink color. I'll try to put it on without mirror and see how it looks like. Hopefully it doesn't look too funny. So there's a nice pale pink color that I found. As you guys know, I love this color. And then I found this black one, which has really beautiful cutout details over here, which I thought is really, really cute as well. So I think it's a really nice way to add a chic little accessory to your outfit in the winter, but at the same time, keep yourself warm because these are mainly made out of wool. So it's actually really warm on your head. And yeah, I really love them. So definitely a favorite of the month. All right, so I have a few beauty favorites that I'm super excited to share with you because these are absolutely useful for everyday use. And I'm going to start with a concealer because a concealer is something everybody needs in, well, not everybody needs to use, but it's good to have in your cosmetic bag. The previous concealer that I had was just too thick and cakey. And again, I talked to my sister, Layla. Layla, if you're watching, I love you. And as always, she has the best recommendations when it comes to beauty products, accessories, anything. She's really awesome. By the way, if you haven't heard of my sister before, her name is Layla and she has a YouTube channel as well, so you can check her out down below. I'm gonna link it. Anyways, so Layla recommended a concealer by the brand Bare Minerals. I like the brand because they don't test on animals. They try to be a bit more on the natural side. They do their best not to use parabens and synthetics. So this one is called Stroke of Light, this product. First of all, I love the name of this concealer, and it actually works as a stroke of light when you apply it under your eyes. I really love the fact that it comes in this application and not some kind of a tube or something where you have to put your finger, because I just don't enjoy those applications. So this one comes with this little applicator, and then you just add it under your eyes, and then you can use your finger or the sponge to sort of blend it under the eye. I really like that this concealer is light, so it's buildable. You can add just one layer or you can add a few. It doesn't really crease. There's so many things I love about this concealer, and that's precisely why it made it into my favorite. So if you're looking for a concealer, I would definitely recommend checking out Stroke of Light by Bare Minerals. All right, I have a couple more favorites when it comes to beauty today, and this one is a lipstick by Josie Maran. This color is called Free Eat Grapefruit, and I got this again at Sephora when I was in Toronto. I recently tried it and I absolutely love the color. It's actually the color that I'm wearing right now. It's not really like a bright pink or anything, but it's sort of in between pink and red, but not necessarily too saturated color. I really like that about this lipstick because that's what makes it really wearable for everyday use. The way they actually promote this lipstick is that it has these properties that supposedly make your lips fuller. And it stings, you know, when you apply, it stings a little bit, but I can actually see a difference in the size of my lips. I really just like the smell of the lipstick. It smells incredible. It smells like grapefruit. And I also absolutely love the color because, again, it's a very neutral color that I believe would work on many different skin tones. So yeah, definitely a favorite of the month. All right, another really incredible favorite of the month is a blush, and this is by the brand Tarte. Tarte is a great brand because, again, they don't test on animals. They do their best to use more natural ingredients in their cosmetics, so I do appreciate that, and I do my best to support these brands. This one is called Blushing Bride, and yet again, it's a product that my sister Layla helped me choose when I was in Toronto. I told her I was looking for a blush, and she said this is a really great neutral color. It works really well if you have a cool skin tone, which I do. If you don't know about color analysis, I'm gonna link my video on color analysis here and down below. So basically, color analysis tells you what season you are, whether you're warm and cool, whether you're summer, winter, spring, or autumn. Based on that, you would know what shades of any color you can actually wear as makeup or clothes. But anyways, going back to the blush, it's really great, beautiful color, perfect for every day. And yeah, I really like the name of this blush. It's called Blushing Bride. Really quickly, I want to mention Productivity Planner, which a lot of you already know about because this is a product that Alex and I and our friend UJ created years ago, and we created it to be more productive in our lives. And I have to be completely honest, after I had Alexa, I stopped using Productivity Planner because my schedule was all over the place, and it took me about a year to sort of create some sort of a work schedule for myself. And now I usually work when Alexa is sleeping. This is my work schedule, is basically to work around her schedule. I recently started to use the Productivity Planner again. And guys, the reason I'm mentioning it today in my favorites is not because I'm trying to promote my product, but really because it makes such a huge difference in the way I feel about the work that I put out there. So a lot of times I just have so many overwhelming thoughts, like in terms of what I need to do. It's all here in your head and you think, oh my God, I have to do this, I have to do that. And like, you really have to put it out somewhere in a planner. The way this planner works is that basically, I'll try to show you just one page. You know, you have just a few tasks that you need to do in the day. So you put the main priority task, and you have to be honest with what that is. Not the easiest, but the one that is the most pressing. So you put that, and then you decide how long you think it's gonna take your time. And then the other tasks go under it. And then basically, the way it works is that when you tackle the task, you work at 25 minutes. So you work in Pomodoros, and when you work at that task, you literally just laser focus on that task. You don't do anything else, you just do that one task. And when you really focus that closely on anything, you actually move through that task. And truly, it is miraculous. When it's all in my head, I feel so overwhelmed and I feel like I have to do so many things. When I actually put it down in my productivity planner, I see that it's actually not that bad. And then I break down my task into different actions and then I actually get them done. And then it feels so much better. So if you struggle with productivity in general, because once you have a child, it's a whole different ballgame. You feel like, you know, you're not getting as much done, especially if you're me and you want to get a lot done. I just feel so much better with the productivity planner. It makes me aware with what I need to do. It makes me happy with what I have accomplished. So yeah, just wanted to mention it briefly because it has been so helpful for me lately. Yet again, I'm so happy I started using it again. And the last favorite of the month is a book that I believe everybody needs to read in their lives. It's a classic. I've read this years ago. It's called How to Win Friends and Influence People. I mean, I haven't read, I listened to it before, and I'm listening to it yet again on Audible. I absolutely love Audible. By the way, everything I mentioned in this video, I'm gonna leave a link down below, so make sure to check out my info box. This book is by Dale Carnegie. It's written years ago. I'm not gonna lie, I can't remember, probably like 60, 70 years ago. So the narration of the book sounds quite outdated, I'll be honest about that. However, if you can go past the narration and that the fact that some of the stories sound a bit outdated, the book is absolute gold. It's about how to improve your relationship with people and how to be a better communicator and how to deal better with people. So basically, anybody who deals with people, if you are a human being and you live on planet Earth, I'm sure you deal with people, will find this book useful. The book gives you practical tips on how to start a conversation, how to engage in a conversation, the importance of using people's names. I feel like that's something we all struggle with. I personally do. I have a hard time sometimes remembering people's names or using them in conversation. I'm not even sure why, but he says it's one of the most important things to do when you're talking to somebody is to use their name repeatedly. And I know when people use my name in a conversation, I always feel good about that. So it just makes you aware of these small things then you can add in your everyday life to improve your relationship with people. And also what I really liked in this book that I picked out this time when I was listening to it is to encourage people more and not criticize. And when I don't like something about someone, I am very vocal about what I don't like to the person that I'm dealing with, whether it's anybody in my life. You know, I'm very honest. But he says it's very important to, instead of criticizing people, focus on what you like in people and encourage these people to do more of that. And you know, when I was thinking about it, I realized it's really just law of attraction. And I've listened and read so many books that talk about this. Anything you want to create more of in your life, focus on that. So obviously if you're gonna criticize and you focus on certain aspects in a person that you don't like and you talk about that, you spend like half an hour talking about that, what are you gonna create more of? You're actually gonna create more of that in that person. So I started using it already and I see it works like a miracle. So I definitely recommend for you guys to read this book. There's so many other incredible messages that I could do a whole video on that, but I'm just gonna stop here. I'll give you a chance to read it yourself and I'd love to hear your feedback once you read it. That is all I have for you guys today. Thank you again for being here, for listening to me. I'd love to hear from you, so leave me a comment down below. Tell me about your favorites of October. I'd love to hear and learn from you. Thanks again for being here. Many kisses, and I'll see you soon. Bye.
Do you like posing?